Hello students, I welcome you all to Brilliant Public Schools online channel. Today we will discuss about chapter 10 circles of class 10th mathematics. So let us see what all terminologies related to circles we will see in this slide. Here let us see. First of all, you can see there are so many common terms that you are so much familiar of. First of all, you have center, the fixed point. Then you have radius, the distance between the center to any point on the circumference. So if here the center is O and this point is A, I can say OA is the radius with center O. Also, we very well know twice of the radius is the diameter. So diameter in this, it is marked, you can say PQ is the diameter of this circle. Also there is the chord. Chord is basically a line segment that joins any two points on the circumference. So here you can see CD is one of the chord. Also you can say PQ is the chord. And don't forget, diameter is the longest chord of a circle. So, and there is one more thing, which is circumference. Circumference being the outer boundary of the circle. So as we say perimeter for the other figures, we say circle has a circumference because of the curved nature. Here we will discuss about circle versus line. So let us see what all things are there. Okay, here you can see we have a line and a circle in the three cases. In the first case, there is no point of contact. You can see the line and the boundary of the circle are not at all touching each other, not at all intersecting. So you can say no point of contact. Then here we have one point. Line PQ is meeting up circle at a single point. And in the third case, you can see a line PQ is intersecting circle at two different points. So this is the only possibility. And if I will talk about few more points, then no doubt I'm talking about the congruency of circle. Because if you have a straight line, then there is only a single chance that they will meet at no point, one point and two points. So let us proceed. Tangent and secant. So here are two new terms for us in this class 10th. So let us see what those terms actually mean. Okay, here you can see the same previous slide we have seen. When we have a line meeting up circle at just one point, the name is tangent. And we have another line that meets up circle at two points. I can mark that as E and F. So this line is meeting up at two points and this we call as secant. So it's very clear where the line will meet at a single point, it is tangent, and where it will meet at two different points, we call it as a secant. Then we have theorem 10.1, and if I'll read the statement, it says the tangent at any point of a circle is perpendicular to the radius at their point of contact. So let us make it more clear by the diagram. Here we go. Here you can see xy is your tangent and the radius is OP. OP is your radius and the point of contact is this point P. So the theorem says wherever the tangent and the radius will meet, we will be getting a 90 degree. So we can say that this angle OPQ is equal to 90 degree. The proof is very simple. The point P is on the circumference as well as on the tangent. So it is on the boundary. But if I will talk about some other points, like see this point A or this point B, they are outside the boundary. That means the shortest distance is PQ. Here I have mentioned the point as well. Perpendicular is the shortest distance between any two points. So it is very clear the points which are in the interior part will be lesser than radius, which are exterior, they will be more than the length of radius, and the point which is on the circumference, the distance will be equal to the radius. So in this condition, PQ will be the shortest distance, and being the shortest distance, PQ, sorry, not PQ, OQ is the shortest distance, and being the shortest distance from the center, it will be 90 degree. Then we have one more theorem, 10.2, and it says the length of tangent drawn from an external point to a circle are equal. You can see by the names also, in both it is written PT1 and PT1. So it makes a clear-cut sense. If you want, you can change also. It could be PQ and it could be PR. So the logic is both the tangents are drawn from the same external point. And if they are drawn from the same external point, they will be equal in length. So let us see. Here, basically, we use congruency and the two tangents drawn from the same point. Congruency includes three of the element, and you can see we have two triangles. First triangle is triangle PQO, and the other one is triangle PRO. In both of these, you can see we have a 90 degree angle Q and angle R. So first condition is angle R equals to angle P because they both are equal to 90. Then we have OP and OP, which is the common side. So that also we can take being the common side. Also we have OP, sorry, not OP, OR and OQ, which is the radii of the circle. So using this condition, you can understand it is a right angle. Then the side opposite to right angle is the hypotenuse. So it is edge and this is side. So by RHS, our triangles are congruent. So now we can take PQ is equal to PR by CPCT, which is the corresponding parts of congruent triangles. So using this criteria like RHS, right angle, hypotenuse side, we can prove these two triangles congruent, and we can take out that the length of the tangents drawn from the same external point are equal. Also, you can say that this angle P is being bisected. Also, you can say this angle O is also bisected. So these all can be used when you will solve the questions of this chapter. Then there is one more point. The tangents drawn at the end point of diameter are parallel. You can see in the figure there is a tangent and one more tangent is there, and both are drawn at the end points of the diameter. So obviously, if I will consider this point O as the center, this angle 1 would be 90 degree because we know by theorem 10.1 tangents and the radius at the point of contact, they make 90 degree, as well as this angle 2 will also be 90 degree. So as we have angle 1 equals to 90, we have angle 2 equal to 90. Also, they are the alternate interior angles. So in this condition, when we have alternate interior angles equal, we can say the lines are parallel. So let us give them a name. If I can take it as AB, your first tangent, and this one SPQ, second tangent. So in this condition, I can say PQ is parallel to AB. So keep in your mind that tangents drawn at the end point of diameter are parallel. So we have discussed the meaning of tangent and secant. Our first theorem, the tangent is perpendicular to the radius through the point of contact, and the length of tangents drawn from the same external point to a circle are equal. Thank you so much, students, for watching the video.